My name is Des Armstrong. The video you are about to watch was shot in 1982 and 1985, almost 40 years ago. It concerns two families and two holidays. The first was when my family and I travelled to Brisbane in Australia to stay with my brother Terry and his family. And then in 1985, they paid us a reciprocal visit to our home in Moira in County Down, Northern Ireland. Our holiday to Australia was the best holiday that we ever had, and I have to tell you that looking at this video brings back so many happy memories. So sit back, relax, have a look, and try to remember those super times.
Take a photo of me. I don't know if you can hear it in the background or not. But here we are on the Murray River, by the way, I should say. That's the deft touch of the master chef. Oh, he's just gone out. Oh, yes. The dreaded 4X in action. And cheers to you too, sir. What a body. Bowen strikes that ball beautifully all over by 20 yards into the trees on the left. Beautiful. Lovely smooth swing on that ball straight into the water. Yes. Have a good game, lads. Good luck, Terry. Pan round and have a look down the fairway. And the first fairway it goes. Rather splendid, don't you think? Unfortunately, the fairways are even fairly well covered in all the debris from yesterday's storm. Where'd you go?
Did you give it?
Yeah. Where'd it go?
Right down the center.
Oh, boy. Oh, beautiful, David. Yes, I like it.
All give me best. Good on you.
Shot,
oh, look at this.
Shot. Look at that, hey.
What the hell's the difference?
Same as an Irish golf club. You're not allowed to use those clubs. They might be alright in Ireland, but we don't use them here.
Just zoom in on what number ball he's using there, please.
And we'd like you to just cut halfway through your shot.
Oh, oh yeah. Have you got where
they have you got it? Have you got it over there?
And here we are on the Gold Coast, by the way, Terrence and Kathy barbecuing. Just pan around the park. Ah, we got some strange looking bird approaching me at the moment. See if I can get a close up of him.
timeless. The County Fire Authority says the worst now seems to be over.
Oh, yeah, that's jeepers. I know I am. Oh, the phone?
And you said it's a busy time, it's just on a mile over here.
I remember that one on the green too.
Yeah, I think so.
That's here.
You got it?
Yeah. This is a view of Brisbane. Sadly, on the day that we're leaving, we're just actually driving to the airport at the moment. We just stopped to get this panoramic view of the city. We're just coming around to the main metropolitan area at the moment. The park that you see in the front, some of the high-rise buildings in the background. Having just enjoyed watching the filming of Brisbane for about the fourth time since we arrived back at 12:30 yesterday, I'm now going to show you what the weather is like back here. This is a view that you'd get looking at, standing on my front doorstep I should say, looking up the park. Houses that you're seeing in shot at the moment were built when you were here 5 years ago, but that house is now on the site where the site had used to be. That's moving on up the park. The white stuff that you see on the ground, oh, that's just the side of my house coming into view. Front doorstep. Oh. My little summer seat, would you believe, at the front of the house? View from the house from the other side. Just showing you a bit of a close-up of the extension, which I did. In fact, I've just noticed that a piece of the leading which I put up has come down. Like you'd know, by the way, I did all that timing myself. And there you have a shot of a couple of our neighbour's children. You can see them all hopped up for our winter weather, and the little doggy. Little dog actually is a pup of the dog of the neighbours who live on the other side. That's a quick shot of people who live next door to us, kids building a snowman. You can see they just got the basic design going. Oh, by the time they finish, it'll be probably, oh, see a little tiny feet at the front, and the next year, young Terence, you and I'll be out doing that. Oh, guys, here's a shot of it actually snowing. This is about the, oops, been home now about 5 days. Snow cleared up for a while, and then it's started up again with the vengeance. If you can see in that shot, it's snowing quite heavily and lying quite thickly. If I come around and let you have a look at the car just to see. Yeah, that's about 2 hours snow, and it's anticipating that it will snow for most of today and all of tomorrow evening. Can you imagine what this place is going to be like? And would you believe somebody out walking a dog even in that?
Buddy, as you probably realise, I'm dubbing over the top of the pictures that you're seeing. What you can hear in the background are us chattering away as we were standing looking out over Royal Port Bress, if you recall, Terence. I'm afraid the quality of the picture isn't that good. It doesn't really show just how beautiful that part of the world is, does it, Terence? I'm panning in and looking down onto the course. It's the fourth fairway that we're looking down, and the green somewhere coming into shot. That's the fairway. Green just coming into shot. Now there she is. Looking on down onto the Atlantic Ocean. Shot of the pro's shop. My shadow in the foreground. Coming round onto the temporary first, and Mark, Terence and Big T warming up. Not quite sure where Ben was then. Young Mark about to play his first shot. Memory serves, young Terry hit a good one here. Yes, he did too. That one went down the middle. Now Mark playing his second. You can see he didn't hit a very good first shot. Hit those massive bunkers on the left, do you recall them? Oh, a nice swing. It's a nice steady sort of a stance there, Terence. Not much of a back. Oh, that's right, you. And that one went down the middle, if you recall. This would have to be the putt of the championships. Look at this, running up and get in the hole. And I haven't been in a golf course. Go on, Ben, get it in the hole. Cracking par. Really, I haven't been in the golf course 5 weeks since you've left. But pint as opposed to drink at the temperature. Big frothy pint of Guinness. Oh. Lovely stuff, eh? Oh, and the celebratory dinner.
The dinner of the Armstrong Masters. Well, I just like to say that
Simon's house, of course, afterwards, when we stopped in the pickup, Mum had already gone. Let us listen to the chatter while I'll add another fag. Ah. This actually happened before the day up at Portrush, of course, and Jackie nearly getting her shoulder blown off. Unfortunately, you recall that we tipped over a lot of the action here. Dead eye Dick approaching.
Yeah, that's all right. Just get theirs here.
Missed again.
How did you switch it off?
Did you just press it again?
Oh dear. Terrence, look at that protrusion. You look bad as mine. Oh! I reckon they were blanks. Oh well, maybe not all of them. And up the graveyard at Kilwarren. I'm afraid I lost the focus here a bit when I tried to show the headstone. You know, the strange thing is that about 2 weeks ago, I was in that graveyard attending a funeral at the foreman in our place. Oh, the chap who organised the shooting, you remember Matt, who owned the gun and the land. His father died. Must have been about 3 weeks after you left. And he was buried in that church, just where the camera's at the moment, just down to the left there somewhere. This was just a shot, you recall that I was still trying to work out how to operate the camera. It's the ski slope at Craigavon where we were down at the driving range.
Well,
about 150.
Aha, straight shot back to Amsterdam. The clock on the Royal Palace in Amsterdam, if you recall. We didn't know what it was at the time, but John told us when we showed him this. That's the palace where Queen Wilhelmina, or her, Queen Beatrice, who was the current Dutch queen. That's the Chinatown area of Amsterdam. All the Chinese restaurants and so forth are all down one of the many canals.
Shop down there. I've a feeling that there could be the...
On the boat we're about to leave on our cruise through the canals. That really does bring me worry, and I just took a shot of that just to show you. These are some of the houseboats that people live in along the canal.
We are now in the single. To the left at number 7.
And those are very old bridges. The clearer water of the main river. Some of the old sailing boats they have there still. It's one of the ferries that they cross. The main river between the, in the background you can see the main railway station. Headquarters of the Shell Company. You can just see the, up in the top middle there you see the Shell insignia. Oh, I'm just pulling in now, yes, you see it quite clearly now.
Oh, yeah.
And here we are back in,
table tennis game.
Oh, yes, about to play table tennis, that's what it was, yes.
I sit here.
Hello, Edward.
Come on, table tennis. Table tennis.
Are you going to play doubles, you and then Brenda against Ken and Maddock? Oh, cracking shot, friends. I bet a better return. 'Cause Ken lives. Shot of the Cross of Sacrifice. All the war commission cemeteries in Europe have those. In fact, quite a number of them over here have them as well. Of course they all have that print too. Their names live us forevermore. Sad to think that every one of those headstones represents a young man of between what, 18 and 25, and all killed in that area around Grosbeck. Terrible slaughter, wasn't it? An awful waste of young lives. It's about 2,300 graves in that cemetery, if you recall. Aha, shop of the place where we got our first glass in Germany. Gee, I wouldn't mind going back to that place for a pint with you, Terry. Oh, a pint, that's a joke. Thimbleful, but still. I'm sure you recall that they had a photograph in the bar of what that place looked like after the war. There wasn't two bricks standing on top of each other. That's all been totally rebuilt since the end of the war. It was totally flattened. Yummy, with a smile for the camera. And Prinsky's bed. Karpov and Korchnoi. Oh, devastating move there. That's got a... Has she got problems? Book. Ah, our walk on the Sunday morning, was it? We went for the walk through the forest. Raining very slightly, as you can see. Yes, that's right. It did come on raining quite heavily, in fact, by the time we got back. Yes, Ken drying his glasses, I think. Cenotaph to the Erborne guys who died at Arnhem. Of course, it's in Arnhem. And panning around there, the rain on the lens of the camera, unfortunately. Panning around to the Hartenstein Hotel, which were the headquarters of the 1st Erborne when they were in that part of Arnhem. This area that we're in actually was the cauldron, the Witch's Cauldron, as the Germans called it, which is where the British had been surrounded and were being blasted to hell and back. One of the Sherman tanks. that would have been used by 30 Corps on the way up to relieve the airborne troops, who of course got there too late, of course, as you well know. But that's typical of the tank that they'd have been using. Could well have been with our pregnant airborne troop. I don't know what the heck he's got up his jumper. Model of some of the horse gliders that were used. You see the black and white markings around the wings and the fuselage. That was to indicate to the troops on the ground and to their own pilots in the air that they were Allied aircraft, because obviously there was so much traffic movement in the air that aircraft recognition always wasn't the best, so the best way to overcome it was to clearly distinguish your own aircraft from the opposition. And to do that, they painted black and white markings. That happened for the D-Day landings, and then all the way through, all the, you see them quite clearly there on the wings. There's no possibility of either fighters or ground crews mistaking those aircraft for German. One of the canisters that the supplies were dropped in. The German Panzer troop, SS actually, you see the insignia on his collar. That's down in the cellar, if you recall, of the Hartenstein. They had it sort of mocked up to look as it looked during the actual operation. That was Urquhart at his desk. The binoculars, by the way, around Urquhart's neck, I think I showed a bit of a close-up. Yes, you see them there, just around his neck, down about his tummy area. They were the actual glasses that he used during the operation. He donated them to the museum. Photographing you. Or maybe you were just trying to get the Hartenstein and I just happened to be in the way. In the summertime, as you can imagine, the whole place is, well, if you can call a graveyard beautiful, it is a beautiful spot. Trees all in foliage, and along by the gravestones I have roses and all kinds of flowers. It really is a beautiful spot. It's sad that so many young men have to lie there dead. Down in that corner, you see down by the sort of sacrifice just to the left there, quite a number of Irish guardsmen buried down in there. Again, all the tankers and so forth, because the Irish guards during the war converted the tanks. Just there, exactly. They were all buried in there. The guys who were killed as they came up the corridor to see airborne troops had opened. Well, you wouldn't have seen it, Terry, but I wrote a poem actually about Arnhem. It's about my last effort actually that I've had typed out and put in my folder with all my other ones. That's a shot of the gravestone of Flight Lieutenant David Lord. He won the VC. You can see the VC inscribed there on the headstone. His aircraft was burning, and he made two runs over the target to try and drop his supplies. Unfortunately, they dropped into German hands, but he wasn't to know that. He stayed with the aircraft until everybody bailed out, and then the wing fell off and he was killed. He was born in Cork, by the way. There, on the bridge itself. The famous bridge at Arnhem. What's in shot at the moment is the end that the British held, and the other end coming into shot now is the end the Germans held. And the River Rhine, of course, flowing quite briskly, as you can see. It's just looking up. That's the road, actually, that the Paris marched down. That was Tiger. They had three roads coming in. There was Land, Tiger, and something else. And that was the one that the 2nd Airborne marched down. You can see how quickly the Rhine is flowing there. And that really is where the British should have landed instead of landing away at Runcombe, but they thought if they landed there it would be too soft. the gliders would bog in and tip over, but in fact it turned out it had been far better doing that. And the that whole area was just totally covered in burned out tanks, armored cars, bodies all over the place. Just some shots of Nijmegen, the tank itself. I just had the cameras, you can see us from the top, you can do it all along. Trick photography, we're now entering Grisbeck, the town of Candidates. And coming down on the left here, as when I swing around and pick out a particular house, this one. That one there. Young Brenda coming to show you how she could click the cards. You've been teaching her how to do that.
Yeah, I have no problem.
Yeah,
we want to
put your legs.
All the plants that the ducks like so much. Here we are at Enniskillen. We went down to see the caves. My car shedding in the foreground. And then Terrence looking like two conspirators. See, you're wearing your thermal underwear. Down inside the cave where they normally, what if you remember, what they did was they put you onto a little punt and they took you 200-300 yards through on an underground stream, but unfortunately, because there'd been so much rain and wet and so forth, the streams were so high that they couldn't do that. You will recall also, of course, that the caves were officially closed then.
Phil?
Huh? Oh, terrible thing to do, Phil. Sorry about that. And because we couldn't use the punts to go underneath the ground, we had to come back up and walk down to the exit. And go backwards as well. Thumbs. That was a quick change. yes, well, here we are playing snooker in Bury. If you recall, we went down on the Friday after we arrived.
Yep.
tries to middle it, put this in the middle pocket. I beg your pardon. I knew he tried to cross it. Paul in the background playing with the rest. Pocket there. I think you and Ken were playing billiards at that stage, if memory serves. Yes, you were. Yes, that's right. You flicked the shot. Well, you flicked most of them, let's face it. Wow. The Friday night. And the closer. Mark, are you very smart for change? I'm going off to take some photographs with the cap still on the camera. To believe anybody looking as sober and upright as that could end up looking the way he did before he left that night. Okay, I'm looking very much the elder statesman. Smile there from the coffee room. And that was Joan pulling the curtains in front of me as I was filming. Window out of focus. I'm practically saying, Terry, that's the only thing Tartan Tiger you're wearing. Yes, I believe it is. Liverpool win the cup or the league or both. And the birthday girl took me 3 shots to get the candles out. Well, Nicole just walked a 10-mile walk this morning, by the way, for charity. And so she'll be a tired little girl when she gets back. Got the cake being passed on. And watch, we actually got a laugh here from Kathy, I believe we do, don't we? Hello. I had thought about editing out the sound of the organ altogether, but I suppose really I'll leave it in for effect. I'm interested in crying. Well, actually not crying, she just had a stinking cool, if you recall. And just as I had the shot all set up, Bill and Susan stood up in front of the camera. quick wedding up. I'm going to edit that bit out as well. Looks like they're racing for some reason, don't they? Came back in again to have the photographs taken inside. I'm giving instructions as usual. Now the two conspirators. You two guys look as if you're really hatching up something, some evil deed. So the wine burns you, what do you think of it? Oh, champagne, sorry. Mmm, yes. Oh, excellent vintage. Just check the label, yes. Mm-hmm. Nice natural shot of gin. Excuse the shooting of the camera though, but I was laughing so much I couldn't hold it steady. Oh, I still find that funny. Oh, that'll teach Ben to fall asleep. Silly. This bit should be edited out, you know. Any person under the age of 18 shouldn't be allowed to watch this. Jesus, his beard is bloody rough there too, on my shoulder. Jesus, Bill, I never knew you were like that. You know, Bill tells me he doesn't remember this. I'm trying to think of it looking at him, he probably doesn't.
Keep the cameras rolling.
And I'm not going to tell you what was happening under there then. Oh, a quick change to a bit of sensible stuff.
Once was a jolly swagman camped by a billabong under the shade of a coolabah tree, and he sang as he watched and waited till his billy boy, "You'll come a-waltzing Matilda with me." Down came a chum buck to drink at the billabong. "I've got the swag," and grabbed him with glee. And he sang as he stowed that jumbuck in his tucker bag, "You'll come a-waltzing Matilda with me." Waltzing Matilda, waltzing Matilda, you'll come a-waltzing Matilda with me. And he sang as he stowed that jumbuck in his tucker bag, "You'll come a-waltzing Matilda." Came the squatter, mounted on his thoroughbred. Up came the troopers, 1, 2, 3. "Who's the jolly jumbuck you've got in your tucker bag? You'll come a-waltzing Matilda with me. Waltzing Matilda, got the swaggy and jumped into the billabong. You'll never catch me alive, said he, and his ghost may be heard as you pass by that billabong. You'll come a waltzing Matilda with me. Waltzing Matilda, waltzing Matilda, Matilda with me, and his ghost may be heard as you pass by that billabong. You'll come a waltzing Matilda with me.
Walking all the day near tall towers where falcons build their nests. Silver winged they fly, they know a call of freedom in their breasts. So black head against the sky, twisted rocks, they run down to the sea. Living on your western shore, saw summer sunsets, asked for more. Stood by your Atlantic sea and sang a song for Ireland. Talking all the day with true friends who try and make a stay. Telling jokes and news and singing songs to pass the time away. Watch the Galway salmon run like silver, dancing, darting in the sun. Living on your western shore, saw summer sunsets, asked for more. I stood by your Atlantic sea and sang a song for Ireland. Drinking all the day in old pubs where fiddlers love to play. Someone touched a bow and played.